In today's video, we're gonna see if a mouse is stronger than an elephant. Let's go! Hello everybody, Wei En Physics here, and this is another episode of 5 Minutes Physics, where you learn physics in less than 5 minutes. So no time wasted. Today's video is all about resultant forces. What are resultant forces? A resultant force is a single force that can represent all other forces on a system. Think about it this way. I have a ball that is being pulled by 8 identical elephants. Now, each elephant is exactly the same size and, most importantly, have the same pulling force. If all elephants pull together, the ball will remain stationary. That is because each elephant is pulling with the exact same force as the elephant opposite of it. Now, what if I replace one of the elephants with an elephant that is just a little bit stronger, that just ate a little too much during the holidays? The ball will start to move towards the stronger elephant. Now, of course, not all of us can afford 8 elephants or even 1 big elephant. But if I want the ball to travel in the same direction at the same speed, I can just connect the ball to a mouse and have that mouse pull in the same direction as a small elephant. So now, in both these cases, the results are the same. So I can say the mouse force represents the forces from all the elephants combined. So the mouse is like the resultant force from all the forces on the ball. Now, our world usually works in 3 axes. So we have the X, Y, and Z axis. That's the 3D world. Mathematics always do things in 2 axes, the X and Y axis. But forget all that. Today, we're only gonna look at forces on 1 axis. That's right, either left and right or up and down. So how do we actually calculate the resultant forces? Now, since we're only looking at 1 axis, we'll just choose one side of the origin as a positive and the other side as a negative. It's up to you which to choose. Then all you have to do is just add up the forces. Now remember, force should always be accompanied by its SI units, the newtons. Let's have a look at the example. 2 people, Alice and Bob, are fighting for gold. What is the resultant force on the gold? So you can see here, Alice is pulling to the left with 3 newtons and Bob is pulling to the right with 5 newtons. For this question, I will assume the right side would be positive and any forces to the left side would be negative. So to calculate my resultant force, I would just add up Alice's negative 3 newtons to the left and Bob's positive 5 newtons, which is to the right, and I'll get a resultant force of 2 newtons. And since my answer is a positive number, I know that the resultant force is towards the right, in this case, towards Bob. Suddenly, Alice jolted her gym boyfriend to come and help her. What is the resultant force on the goal now? So Alice and her boyfriend are both pulling to the left with 3 newtons and 9 newtons respectively. So to calculate my resultant force, I will add negative 3 and negative 9. And also, I will add in Bob's original 5 newtons to the right. In the end, I'll get an answer of negative 7 newtons. And since the resultant force is negative, I know that the resultant force is towards the left, or in this case, towards Alice. So Bob called up his Puchong gang. What is the resultant force on the gold now? Again, I just have to add up the forces according to the direction. Negative 9 and negative 3 on the left side, positive 5 by 3 people on the right side. The result is 3 newtons, which is a positive number, so the resultant force is towards the right. Now, Mr. Muscle didn't want to lose, so he called his other girlfriend. So now, on the left side, we have negative 3 from Alice, negative 9 from Mr. Muscle, and negative 3 from the girl he was cheating on with. On the right, we have our Puchong gang, plus 5, plus 5, and plus 5. When you add all these numbers together, the resultant force is 0. And a 0 newtons resultant force will mean that the goal will remain stationary, just like our ball. So that is all for resultant forces. If you enjoyed the video, remember to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more physics related content. I am Wei En Physics, and that was another episode of 5 Minutes Physics. I'll see you in the next video. Remember, never stop learning.